Hi there, in this video, we'll set up product reordering in inFlow. Setting up reordering will help make sure you always have enough products in stock. Let's say you own 3 retail stores and a main warehouse for storing most of your inventory. When one of your store locations runs low on stock, inFlow will help you transfer stock from your main warehouse to your store's location. And when your warehouse starts to run low, inFlow will let you know when to buy more products from your vendors. Let's set this up in inFlow. From the homepage, click on the product list. From here, select a product to assign reorder points to. Under Reorder Settings, click on Edit Reorder Settings. On this screen, you'll see the Last Vendor field, a search bar to filter locations, and a list of all your locations below. In this example, there are 4 locations. 3 retail stores and a main warehouse. Toggle on a location for reordering. You have the option to set a default location, like a bin or an aisle, for where this product is usually stored. If you don't already have sublocations in inFlow, you can type one in now. As mentioned, when the main warehouse runs low, it restocks by buying more from vendors. This means the reorder method needed here is purchase orders. Select your preferred vendor from the drop-down menu. Below, set your reorder point. This is the quantity level your product must go below for inFlow to let you know you're low in stock. If the reorder point is set to 500, then when the product quantity is at 499 or lower, inFlow will let you know to reorder. Below is the reorder quantity. This is where you could set how many products you should reorder. If you're unsure what to add, you could look at the recommended reorder point report as a guide. It could suggest reorder points and reorder quantities based on your past sales and your vendor lead time. When you've filled everything out, repeat the process for the next location. To start, toggle on the reorder settings for this location. Then select a default sublocation if you'd like. For this example, we'll set the reorder method to stock transfer. In the location drop-down menu, we'll select the main warehouse, since this is where the store locations will be transferring their inventory from. Next, we'll enter the reorder point and reorder quantity. For this example, we'll repeat the process for the 2 remaining locations. When everything is complete, click Done. If your company manufactures products, then you can set the reorder method to work order. Doing this will create a work order with the quantity needed based on the reorder point and reorder quantity you've set. Now you're all done. You can repeat these steps for other products to set up reordering. If you reorder many products and setting this up one by one will take too long, then you could set up the reorder settings in bulk with a CSV import. Check out the link in the description for details. Now, on to how to reorder in inFlow. Now that the product reorder settings are in inFlow, let's take a look at how it works. If you're subscribed to Low Stock Emails, you could take a look there to see which products need to be reordered. Otherwise, you can click on Reorder Stock from the homepage. On the reorder screen, you'll see a list of locations you have access to. Select a location to view what's low in stock there. In this example, the default location for all inventory is the main warehouse. We'll take a look at this location first. You'll see that to restock the products in this location, both purchase orders and work orders are going to be used to replenish the stock. Under purchase orders, you'll see the vendors you'll reorder from. If you click on the arrow to the right of the vendor names, you'll see all the products you'll be ordering from them. If you want to change the vendor for a specific product, you can click on the person symbol to the right of the product and select another vendor from the drop-down menu. After reviewing the products to reorder, put a check mark next to either the reorder method to reorder from all vendors, or you could select which vendors you want to choose from. The second reorder option on the screen is work orders. work orders are used to assemble products together. This is a plan add-on for manufacturing or putting kits together. Click on the down arrow next to work orders to see which products need assembly. In this example, the products getting assembled are gift boxes. This will take different component products and combine them into one product. Now that everything looks good, let's select both purchase orders and the work orders and then click the reorder button. Next, you'll see a summary on screen of all the orders that have been made. You can click on the box and arrow symbol to open the newly made orders. For work orders, you'll notice the Microsoft Windows symbol next to those orders. You could view those orders in the inFlow Cloud for Windows app. After clicking on a purchase order from the reorder screen, a new tab will open to show that order. From here, you can process it normally. Let's take a look at reordering for one of the store locations. As a recap, these stores don't reorder with purchase orders. They only transfer stock from the main warehouse as needed. The process to reorder will start the same way, by opening the reorder stock screen. The only reorder method on screen is stock transfer, since the main warehouse holds most of the inventory. To get an idea of what products need to be transferred to this location, click on the down arrow next to the transfer location. If you want to change where a product is being transferred from, you can click on the location symbol to the right and select another location from the drop-down menu. When done, select all the products you want to transfer, whether all the products or just a few from the list, then click reorder. Once the stock transfer has been created, you can click on the order and it will open in a new tab for you to process. If you open the reorder screen and notice an orange bar at the top of the screen, this means you have products that are low in stock that don't have reorder settings in place. To set the reorder settings, click on the arrow. Like the other product reorder settings, you can set the default sublocation, reorder method, reorder point, and the reorder quantity. After you've filled out everything, click on Complete and Add to Reorder. And that's it. You could continue to use inFlow and be rest assured you won't run out of stock. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to the inFlow team. You can find contact details on screen or linked in the description. Thanks for watching.